Welcome back to the sixth example exam question. Let's just go ahead and get started. By now you know the drill, so let's jump in. This is the question that we're going to review in this lesson. The question is that you're auditing the AWS environment for the Catagram Enterprise application. It runs from EC2 instances provisioned via an auto-scaling group connected to an application load balancer. A sysadmin team manages the AWS and EC2 environment, and development teams connect to EC2 when they perform application maintenance. You're adding SSL capability and need to ensure the development team who have root access to the EC2 instances can't access the SSL certificate for Catagram.io. Which solution should you suggest? Choose one. By now, you should be getting pretty good at analyzing these questions. So give it a go, pause the video while you do, and when you resume, we can compare what points I found versus yours. Okay, so let's compare what you discovered versus the points that I identified. Now this one isn't too complex. I've highlighted the block of text which gives an overview of the environment because it might matter. So EC2 instances provisioned via an auto-scaling group connected to an application load balancer. Then we have two teams, a sysadmin team who manages AWS and EC2, and a development team who connect to EC2 instances, and that could be important, so both of those I've highlighted. You're also told that the development team have root access, and this suggests Linux EC2 instances, but beyond that it also suggests that the development teams have unrestricted access to everything inside the instance, so everything inside the operating system the development team have access to. And the question requires that you prevent the development team having access to this SSL certificate whilst the environment has to continue operating correctly. So this is a fairly tricky question that requires knowledge of all of the individual parts. It requires knowledge of SSL, how to configure SSL on Linux-based instances, and then how permissions work within an AWS environment and within an operating system. So it's a lot more challenging than it appears at first glance. Now the question requires you pick one answer, and as I just mentioned, it's clearly focused on knowledge of role separation and SSL usage between instances and load balancers. So let's look at the answers that we have for this question. Now we have a total of four answers for the question, and notice how the last two have very similar wording, and that's key because it means that we can speed up the review process for all of these answers by just identifying the differences between the last two answers, and then the last two answers and everything else. So go ahead and pause the video and just spend some time analysing the answers, identifying what you think matters, and then when you resume, we can review this together. Now let's step through the key points that I identified in the answers, and the way that I tackle this question to speed things up is to notice, as I'd mentioned previously, that the top two answers and the bottom two share something. The bottom two answers both use ACM, and the top two don't. So if you can quickly identify whether ACM should be used in the solution or not, it can help you immediately eliminate 50% of the available answers. Now you do actually have enough information to make this decision from the question text, but only if you understand a few really important points. The first important point is that the aim is to stop the development team from accessing the SSL certificate. The development team have root access to the EC2 instances, and this means any security which relies on the operating system within the EC2 instances can be rendered invalid by the development team simply changing those permissions because they have root access, and you can't restrict or prevent the root user on a Linux machine changing permissions. So the top two answers both rely on how EC2 security is configured. The top answer, which is to store the SSL certificate on S3 and copy it into the instance at boot, then load it and remove it afterwards. Well, with this answer, anyone with root access can just remove the part which removes the certificate at the end, and then they have access to the certificate. So if the certificate is loaded onto the instance at boot and a rogue developer simply removes the line of the script that deletes the certificate after it's loaded, then they will have access to the certificate. Anyone with root access can make changes to any security configuration on that instance. And so that means the top answer is eliminated as invalid. And with the second answer, even if you could set operating system level permissions to only allow an IAM group access, well, any user with root permissions can remove this restriction. And for the record, you can't do this anyway. Permissions in Linux are POSIX-based permissions, so internal to that instance or file system. You can't set IAM users or groups on POSIX permissions within a Linux operating system, at least not by default. So if you see this style of question in the exam, which suggests SSL and role separation, then think ACM. It's usually going to involve ACM. Now, ACM as a service can store certificates and distribute them to supported services, and you can tightly control the security of those certificates. Now, if we focus on the bottom two answers, both of them share a lot of wording. Both of them use ACM, and both of them can configure it so the application load balancer makes use of the SSL certificate managed by ACM. But there are two differences. The first difference is whether the certificate is generated by ACM or imported into ACM. That's difference number one. And the second difference is whether the instances use HTTP or HTTPS to communicate with the load balancer. Now, ACM is capable of generating or importing certificates, and so that doesn't influence the answer that we pick. The key part of selecting between these remaining answers is actually the protocol that the backend instances use. If they use HTTPS, then it means that the instances need a valid SSL certificate. It needs to be a valid, publicly trusted SSL certificate in order for it to work. If the backend instances use HTTP, then they don't need an SSL certificate. Now, if the instances have the SSL certificate on them, it means that the development team who have root permissions will be able to access that SSL certificate. And so it means that we can't use answer 3 because this will provide the development team access to the SSL certificate. Because we're using HTTPS for the backend instances, they'll need a certificate installed, and the whole point of this is to prevent the development team from having access to this certificate. So answer 4 is the right answer. This architecture is called SSL offload, where connections to the load balancer use HTTPS, and then connections from the load balancer to the instances use HTTP. It means that the instances don't need to use SSL certificates at all, it's less admin overhead, and it means that the SSL certificate can be tightly controlled. Now, I hope this makes sense. I'm trying to get you used to identifying the key parts of all of these questions and all of these answers. I want you to get used to finding the information which matters in questions quickly and efficiently. That's the key to getting good exam marks. Okay, well, that's everything for this lesson. Thanks for watching. Go ahead and complete the lesson, and when you're ready, I look forward to you joining me in the next.